Hey y'all, it's your friendly neighborhood therapist, and I am in color today instead of my normal black and white video because it's sunny and the sun is coming through my blinds really nice, and I happen to like this ombre lip that I got going today. But anyway, I came on here to talk to y'all today a little bit about shame. It came up on a friend's post about a particular subject matter that is trending, and I just want to talk to y'all about shame for just a minute, so let's get into it. All right, so context. The idea of shame has come up the last couple of days due to the 1994 Freaknik documentary that is supposed to be coming out on Hulu. And some of the people of that time, the generation of that time that got to go to Freaknik. I'm so mad that it was over by the time I got to college. I'm a zennial. I think that's the older millennials. Yeah, I'm in my upper 30s. So anyway, a lot of the Gen X, because that's the generation that basically did get to go to Freaknik, those were their college years, feel like the younger generations are trying to shame them or make them feel ashamed about what will be shown in this documentary. Now, mind you, clips of Freaknik are all over YouTube anyway. They've been all over YouTube for years. But let me just clarify, at least for me and most of the people my age that I know, it is not about making anyone feel ashamed of what they did. What it is about is highlighting the hypocrisy of that particular generation now. Because you see, people get older and forget when they were once young. And people in that generation have gotten older, and now all of a sudden they fall into respectability politics. And they try to shame younger generations for doing some of the very same things that they did. So that's most of our hangup. Like, all right, we about to see how much of a fool y'all acted and how much fun y'all had and how you now come down on younger generations and why. That is the time of your life that you are supposed to be having fun. Now, I'm not going to use this video to talk about the other horrible part of Freaknik, which was all the sexual assault that occurred. I hope they show that in the documentary, but I'm not going to use that for this because I'm focusing on shame itself. That's the background of why I wanted to talk about shame today, though. So let's keep going. So on a friend of mine's post, he was basically saying, you know, my generation is not going to feel ashamed about this. We're just not. Although there are many who do. There are many who do not want this to air, and they've said as much. But someone on his post basically said, well, what is wrong with feeling shame? Maybe if more people, more of the younger generation, more people in general felt shame, they wouldn't do certain things. So that's what I want to get into. All right, so first let's define the word shame. Dictionary definition of shame is a painful feeling of humiliation or distress caused by the consciousness of a wrong or foolish behavior. All right, so by definition, shame is a humiliation and distress. This is what you feel when you feel shame or ashamed, humiliation or distress. Now, in what world would anyone ever want anyone to feel humiliated or distressed? But if you were to go to the Googles right now and Google, is there a such thing as healthy shame? You're going to get a yes, because some people do differentiate between maladaptive, unhealthy, toxic shame and healthy shame. But I don't agree with using the word shame at all, because that word means what it means. There's no healthy way to make someone feel humiliated or distressed. The word that we would really want to put here is guilt. Sometimes guilt is appropriate to feel. And let's look at that definition. The basic definition, guilt is the fact of having committed a specified or implied offense or crime. But the feeling of guilt is a feeling of deserving blame, especially for either a real or imagined offense or from a sense of inadequacy. Also, guilt is about self-reproach. And all self-reproach is reproach or blame directed at yourself. So basically, accountability. All right, so now the question becomes, so what's the difference between shame and guilt? Well, one, I define them and clearly they have different meanings, but the majority of shame researchers and people who and clinicians who like really, really work in shame, most researchers and clinicians agree that the difference between shame and guilt is best understood as the difference between saying I am and I did. Let's talk about that. So let's say that you just did something that is deemed quote unquote bad or wrong, whatever. Okay. Something that most people would say that you should either feel ashamed about or feel guilty for. To make you feel ashamed about it or to have a feeling of shame about it, you are saying, I am bad. I am a horrible person. Guilt, on the other hand, is saying, I did a bad thing. I did a horrible thing. See, that's different. One focuses on self, the other focuses on the behavior. So, see, when we focus on self saying, I am bad or I am horrible, that starts to embed itself into our psyche, and that this is who we think we are at that point. I grew up, one of my uncles was very adamant, and still to this day, he is very adamant. Whenever somebody, he hears somebody say, oh, he just bad, she just bad, in reference to a child, he is quick to say, don't call that baby bad. And I never understood why, but that's why he was saying that. When you call a child especially bad, they internalize that. So now they grow up thinking, well, I'm bad anyway, so I might as well do whatever's deemed bad because that's what I am. This is why it's important to differentiate between the self and the behavior. Telling a child, this was a bad thing you did, but that does not make you a bad child or a bad person. I still love you, whatever may have you. That's important to differentiate because now they realize I don't have to feel ashamed. I should feel guilty and be held accountable and maybe feel some remorse, but shame is different. Remember, shame focuses on the self. Guilt, remorse, accountability, that focuses on the action, the behavior. That takes it, that separates it from you as the person, okay? And to circle back to where this all started, how I got to talking about shame, with this documentary that's coming out on Hulu, for anyone to make someone feel ashamed of who they used to be or what they did in the past is already foolish. There is no way you should be feeling ashamed for something that is past tense. There's no reason to feel distressed or humiliated about something that is already done and over with, period. But that being said, realize that it's really healthy to look at things and think to yourself, I cannot then shame someone else for actions that I myself once did. Now, some people will hear that and say, well, it's not about shaming them. It's about teaching them. I lived it, so I know. So I'm trying to tell you what not to do. You had to live it for yourself. My grandmother raised us. You have to let children, teenagers, whoever, live things for themselves. You can tell somebody what they should be doing, and that has nothing to do with the choices they are going to make for them. People have to bump their own heads. They have to walk their own journey. You walk yours. Let other people walk theirs without drenching them in shame. So to wrap us up with just a nice little bow, I got a question for y'all. What have you been saying to yourself about you? What have you been calling yourself based on your actions and behaviors? Have you been putting things on yourself, saying, I am this, I am a bad person, I am a horrible person, I am a bad mom, wife, sister, cousin, brother, son, daughter, friend? Have you been saying you are a bad thing? Or have you been looking and saying, I did a bad thing, I messed up, I made a mistake? Because it's different, and you will feel different if you start to tell yourself, focus on the actions and behaviors of yourself and others, instead of the person, separated from the person. And it makes a world of difference because we don't need to be having anyone out here feeling ashamed of anything. Shame can never be a good thing in no form or fashion. What you feel when you think about how would my parents feel about this or how would my kids feel about this, that's your conscience telling you maybe don't do this thing. And then if you go ahead and do the thing and they do find out, you might feel a little bit guilt. Feeling guilt or remorse or taking accountability is fine. But shame, we got to stop that. You are not that. We are multifaceted human beings and we are imperfect. So we're all going to mess up. That doesn't mean that we are a mess up. Okay? You're special. You're wonderful. You make mistakes. That's it. You might do bad things or have done something bad, but that's life. Start speaking to yourself in a different way. Focus on the behaviors and the actions and not the person. All right, y'all. Have a beautiful, wonderful rest of your day, and I'll holla at y'all later.